without a woman on.
This is your mess.
I think you're losing it.
Whoa, whoa!
You just do not know what is gonna happen, and then you're like, ah! It did just happen, and it was so fun.
This is my girl.
Okay, yeah, yeah, no, I need you at every premiere from here on out. I think this is what white girl heaven must be like.
Huh?
This is what white girl heaven must be like. Yeah.
Super fun film.
Thank you.
What was the funnest scene, would you say?
The
whole football sequence was like
very intense,
but the funnest to film. You know what? I really liked when we did like the dance, like little party thing that we didn't know.
That was fun. It was the scene where it was after we've completed the big heist and where everybody's kind of hanging out and just drinking and.
After the New Orleans
section.
It wasn't in the script, but the directors kind of started. We got up there and they're like, just go stand over there, and then. They put on music and like started popping bottles of champagne. They're like, everyone just have a party. We're gonna film it. And it was really, really cool.
And they ended up putting it in the film.
Yeah.
It was great.
That's so cool. Now, your character is the dream. Not only so smooth, but just so secretly romantic too. Are you similar in real life? He's very thoughtful. I can imagine him being very, very, you'd be.
Yeah, I think I
romantic.
I'm pretty romantic. Yeah, I think I am.
I know from my perspective, he's extremely thoughtful. Like when we were in Argentina, and I was upset that I was missing out on Christmas back home, he found a Christmas tree in Argentina somehow and bought the decorations so I could put up a Christmas tree. Very thoughtful.
Yeah, I guess I am.
Or like when I want tea, you'd find tea.
Yeah, I got you tea because you like tea. Mm. Yeah. Actually, now that I think about it, I'm very romantic.
Now, in the film, we see some serious good game. Really good game.
Yeah.
I have terrible game. What are your top tips for getting the person you fancy?
Forgetting the person you fancy.
Ah. Well, the oldest trick in the book, treat a man, keep him king. Do you think that works? Yeah, I do, to an extent.
Yeah, to an extent.
It's treat him mean, but like, don't be like, horrible, but
yeah.
Nikki took it a little too far.
Yeah.
This is a bit where Nikki was a little too mean.
Yeah, see, but disinterest is a very powerful tool of attraction. But it's like, it's almost, it has to be like fishing though. You can't just not be interested.
Yeah.
But it worked for you with the movie. Because Margot came to the audition with no.
Everyone's gonna think I didn't wanna do this movie.
No, you didn't. You definitely didn't.
I rocked up to the audition. I didn't look my best, obviously.
No. It's not that you didn't. I hadn't gotten ready
because I didn't have the means to get ready.
She says that they lost her luggage.
They did lose my luggage. I had been awake for 50 something hours. It was ridiculous.
You should get a nap before an audition, though.
Right? I did. I had 6 hours sleep in 50.
Cannot believe you lied to me.
You can't believe I lied?
Can't believe.
Oh, that's so rich for me.
That's what you want to say to me.
Because you're always lying, Nikki, and now we're dead.
And lastly, have you ever faked your identity when someone's come up to you and said, oh my God, you're, and you're like, no. All the time.
Yeah, it doesn't work for me too well. Generally, I'm like, no, I'm Denzel.
Do people ever come up and be like, Denzel? Or like,
no, one time in India, I was at the Taj Mahal. And a guy walks up to me and says, oh, I know you. And I was like, yeah, sir, can you just, please, because I don't want to, I just want to be able to enjoy. He said, Eddie Murphy.
Hold on. That's me.
That's me.
That's amazing. You got it.